Welcome to a new update. The planetary geometry that I discussed in the previous update. Quick recap. We have Venus, Sun, Saturn in a conjunction. It was yesterday night. And also Venus, Mars and Uranus in a 90 degree angle. And this morning we have Mercury, Venus and Jupiter also in a 90 degree angle. And that is a critical convergence. And we already have had some stronger seismic activity yesterday, as you can see over there on the SGI graph. With the convergence of the critical planetary geometry on the 28th, we had three strong tremors peaking magnitude 6.6 deep below Fiji. And this is very similar to what we had on the 21st, 22nd of April. And that's on this side of the SGI graph. And we see this huge clustering of stronger earthquakes at the time and following that critical planetary geometry. It means that we are likely to have stronger seismic activity later today, tomorrow, maybe May 1st. It's difficult to say exactly how Earth is going to respond to the incoming electromagnetic energy from the planets and the solar system. But expect a stronger seismic activity later today, tomorrow. And we are going to look at the atmospheric fluctuations to see where larger earthquakes are more likely to occur. It isn't perfect, but it may be a significant indicator. We had some additional fluctuations since the last update, and they happened north of South America, well, near Panama and just to the North Caribbean plate. This could indicate stronger seismic activity of South America, possibly Ecuador, but also to the North Central America. That's difficult to say. We had tiny fluctuations, it wasn't really much, near the New Britain region and also the Aleutian Islands, and finally Asia, northeastern part of China, and to the south, the Nicobar Islands, Andaman Islands region, and northern Sumatra. I also would like to look at the atmospheric fluctuations that we had earlier in the Middle East, near the Middle East and Asia. We had a fluctuation on the 21st that was pretty much the same region where we had a fluctuation on January 29th, also eastern Turkey and the western part of Iran, northern part of Iraq. And that happened on 29th January, 8 days before the major earthquakes in central Turkey. So as you can see, it can happen a little bit to the west or to the east of the fluctuation. It isn't perfect. We cannot pinpoint exact locations with these fluctuations. That's not just possible. And on the 22nd of April, we had these strong fluctuations north of Pakistan, Afghanistan. This could indicate stronger seismic activity in China, but also to the south, Afghanistan, Pakistan possibly. And I also marked Iran here, which may also be affected. And then on the 24th, we had also fluctuations marking the central part of Iran and to the south towards Africa. It is impossible to say if these areas are going to be affected, but these fluctuations are a significant indicator, it is possible. So be on watch in the next few days. There's likely to be more stronger seismic activity similar to what we had yesterday. It could be higher 5 magnitude towards magnitude 6. It could be well into the 6 magnitude range and maybe even magnitude 7. So be on watch just in case. Until next time.